Okay, so a video I've been promising to do for a while. I keep putting it off because there seems to be more and more content all the time. So I'm always like, well, I'll wait another week if this is coming in the mail. But, and there is something coming on Tuesday, and then probably the week after, and who knows. But I'm going to do a video on my 4K collection to this point. One thing I want to mention first, because I've been, you know, I watch YouTube on and off, and I watch other people's reviews, and there's some really good people out there who are honest and try to show you what's what. Isn't about money, it's just about the technology and talking about it. And there are others I'm kind of noticing now that are doing reviews based on content they either don't own, or if they own the content, they don't have the equipment to actually do a review based on that. I've noticed there's somebody who's doing these 4K reviews now, and they're doing reviews before movies are even released. So they're either going to 4K.com or Blu-ray.com and reading the reviews if they get theirs up early, and I don't even know if those are legit, and then sort of taking like the image from Blu-ray.com or Amazon or Best Buy, and then they're putting it in their thumbnail. But then when you watch the review video, they can't show any content on the screen. And I fully understand that, because that's really about, you know, you do risk a lot when you try to put things up on YouTube like I do, because I do get them taking things down. And to me, it's like, whatever, it's not my job. I don't do this for a living. I'm talking to like-minded people. I don't care how many subscribers I get or views I get, as long as it helps somebody make a decision who likes this sort of thing, and we can have a good discussion with cool people, with sane people, whatever. But as I'm starting to see these people throwing up reviews of content that they don't own, throwing it in their thumbnail, and they can't even show you anything content-wise, or even show you the package, the case that the movie came in, because they don't have it, that's really disgusting. That's pretty underhanded. Like, that stuff needs to stop. You know what I mean? Don't try to screw people over just to get views if you don't own the content, because this is a very tight community of people who like this sort of thing, and we're communicating on each other based on reality. How do you do a TV calibration video without even showing your television? It's not like YouTube would take that video down. If you showed your 4K TV and are calibrating it, how many videos have you seen like that? I've seen tons of them. So be very careful who you look to for some of this information on here, because there's some people who just, for whatever reason, think that's okay and don't think most people are smart enough to notice. So yeah, just watch it. Anyway, let's get down to this business. Again, 1316 Killer, he buys the stuff. So you know when he's talking to you, he's not lying to you. The 4K upscaler, more focus on games, he's showing you the content. You know he's not lying to you. You know, I don't have any dog in the hunt of what either of them do, or, you know, I've watched a lot of their videos, and I know if they convey some information, I know they're not lying about it, because it's based on real testing. So, okay, I'll get off my high horse, and let's just get to the collection. I'll try to go through this really quickly. So the first movie is John Wick. John Wick, I just did a review on it. I know some of you have probably seen it. Unfortunately, in parts of the UK, it was blocked, so I'm sorry for that. Little John Wick here, though. Yeah, John Wick. Anyway, back to John Wick. Amazing film. Dolby Atmos audio, 7.1 if you don't have Atmos. 4K digital intermediate. This is definitely one of the films I think anybody has to own in their collection if you like this kind of movie. To me, this is the kind of thing I've been waiting for in 4K, that as a repurchase, I already own this in Blu-ray, is a no-brainer to me, because this is just a great film. So I would definitely recommend picking up John Wick if you don't have it on Blu-ray. And even if you do, it is a worthy upgrade. Mad Max, among the first batch of movies I owned with my 4K set, when I got my Samsung player, I actually started pre-ordering these before the player arrived. It's not a 4K digital intermediate. I think it's 2K, but it looks spectacular. Audio-wise, it's amazing. It's a great film. The HDR really gives it that pop. definitely something you should have in your collection 4K wise. I'm going to try to go through these really fast because I did a 47 minute video in 4K, and you can imagine how long that took to try to upload. Pineapple Express. This is one of the first movies I really started talking about. I think this movie might be a 4K transfer, but it's breathtaking regardless. I mean, some of the details you see in this film, it's a very simple movie, but I mean, the detail in things like Seth Rogen's jacket and just everything is so well done. The handling of the shadows when they're in the forest and the audio quality. And the movie is really, this is a very funny movie, so I would definitely say picking this up, because you also get it at a discounted price versus what a lot of these 4K Blu-rays cost nowadays. Another one of my first pickups, The Kingsman. Didn't like this movie the first time I saw it, but when I gave it a second chance and sort of recalibrated my thinking on the film that it wasn't supposed to be James Bond, it was supposed to be more kick-ass, I really like this film. It's a very, very clean transfer. I don't know how much it really gives you the HDR. I don't think it's really relying so much on the HDR. This seems to be more about just 4K detail and the luminance that you get more so from 4K than the actual range of color variants. But this is a good transfer to pick up, a good movie to pick up. Well, I mean, this is the movie I rave about. It's the highest viewed movie of any of the videos I've put up. To me, this is just pure reference. It's not a 4K digital intermediate, but it's just because of the way the film was shot. All natural light. It's just beautiful. It is breathtaking. It's cut with a razor. The movie's amazing. The audio quality is spectacular. I run a 7.1 system. So if you're running a surround sound system, this is something to truly appreciate. And any person with a 4K setup, this is a movie that you should have as a in your collection, even if you're just going to show it off to people. But must buy Revenant. Lone Survivor, a movie I was not going to pick up because I own it on Blu-ray. It looks spectacular on Blu-ray, but I had a gift card and I got this for like $15 about a week and a half ago, and it's a cleaner version of the Blu-ray, let's just say that. It's with the HDR that you get more variance in colors as well. You get, you know, a brighter image. You get better handling of the colors in the shadow areas. Everything is just crisp. It's perfect, and it's a great film to boot. A lot of action, fast paced. It's a Peter Berg film, so just like Deepwater Horizon. I think this is one I'd pick up. It's also, again, one of the 4K films that's been released at a more discounted price than some of the other films. So I would recommend this movie as well if you don't already own it on Blu-ray. Da Vinci Code, 4K digital intermediate. I read the book years ago. Didn't buy the Blu-ray because I liked the book, but I rented the Blu-ray. Didn't like the movie. I picked this up because it came out in a 4K digital intermediate, and it was one of the few movies at the time that did, so I picked this up. And I have to say, it is breathtaking. It is beautiful to look at. But if you weren't a fan of the movie originally, might not be worth it. Now that you're starting to get more movies that are 4K digital intermediates, just wait for the content that you really want. But if you want some eye candy and you like traveling and you like some of the sights you're going to see in this film, I would suggest picking it up. If you're a fan of the film, I would also suggest picking it up. Watchmen. Okay, now this is a tough one for me because I love this movie. This is one of my favorite superhero movies. I bought the graphic novels as a kid, and I really liked the fact that it was hard for me to get over that they didn't have superheroes I recognized, but once I started reading it, I just got really into it. And the movie is such a faithful adaptation of the comic book, especially when you get the ultimate cut because it adds in the tales of the Black Freighter stuff. I think it's a great transfer. It's not the best transfer. There's some grain in certain areas, but where you really start to get the HDR and the detail, it's a beautiful transfer, especially if you're watching on something like with an OLED or you have a full array backlight and you get the most out of the brightness uniformly across the screen and the shadow detail. There are moments where this movie is just breathtaking. Again, I'm biased because I love this movie so much, so I would definitely say picking it up. I noticed on Best Buy, this thing is always sold out online. Since the day it was released, pretty much, you can't get it. but I would pick it up if you have a chance to do so. The Accountant. Transfer-wise, beautiful. Audio-wise, beautiful. Movie-wise, I thought it was okay. It's Ben Affleck seems to be trying so hard to get his Jason Bourne, you know, get his recurring character to sort of get, you know, to bankroll that kind of stuff. I've watched it twice, you know, and I'm just, it's okay, and I can see that they're going to try to probably make a number of sequels to this, but it has its moments, but it's not something I would pick up at full price, to be honest with you. If you're just about audio and video, yeah. If you're about good movies, which is what a lot of this is about, whatever people tell you. I don't care how many pixels something have. If a movie's garbage, it's garbage. It doesn't matter how many pixels you wrap around it. This movie's good, but it's not great. So if you have a lot of other choices, make another choice. Life of Pi. Another reference movie to me. I'm pretty sure this isn't a 4K digital intermediate. I have so much content now, and I've bought things over the months, I'm forgetting. But quality-wise, this is reference. Audio-wise, this is reference. Movie-wise, this is a spectacular movie and should be in your collection if you like good film. So definitely worth a pickup. The Martian, also among my first batch of pickups. Same as Life of Pi, great film. Great video, great audio. Like, it's a beautiful looking movie, and definitely a movie you want to own for every reason. In this case, audio, video, movie quality wise, great pickup. Lucy. This movie is beautiful. This movie is breathtaking. Movie itself isn't great. Good concept. They could have done a better job with it. Out of 5, I would give it a 3, but audio and video quality wise, it's definitely a 5. It's spectacular, and if you can get this at a discounted price, as I did on Black Friday week, I would pick it up. If you're just looking for eye candy, I'd pick it up. Especially people, when you have like larger displays, when you start getting into the 65 inches bigger projectors mostly, and you have a good player like the Oppo or the Panasonic, or any of the 4K players are pretty good, but if you really have high-end equipment, this is, and you have a projector, a larger display to take advantage of more pixels, this is a movie that I think you want to show off. Shallows. Did a video for this, actually. You know, I'm a grain of sand on YouTube compared to other YouTubers. When you're on a beach full of a bunch of boulders, I'm a grain of sand. But based on my subscriber count to the views I got for this movie, I got a lot of views, and I hope it helped people make a decision. But the fact is, this movie is breathtaking. It's not 4K, but it is reference. It is gorgeous. Again, like the Revenant, just because of the nature of the movie and the sort of cinematography, it is spectacular when you add the HDR and the brightness to the water and everything else that you get in the sunlight. It's amazing. I also really liked the film. Ending was a little bit weak, but the film itself it had me really wrapped up in it. And My review, unfortunately, was just taken down by YouTube after like 8 months. But hey, again, it's not my content. I'm not complaining about that. I understand that. But if this is definitely also something I pick up. This is stuck at like $56 here in Canada since it was released. I got it at $32. Sorry, for a week after, just before pre-order was released. They had it at $55. I waited. Dropped it to 32, I pre-ordered it, and I noticed a week after it was released, it went back to 55, and it's stuck there ever since. Would I buy this for $55? I don't know about that, but it's definitely something to be in your collection. Pacific Rim. Good movie. Beautiful, beautiful in 4K. This is spectacular. This is being upscaled, I believe, but audio and sound quality wise, sound quality wise, audio obviously, and video quality wise, this is a pretty amazing film. There are a lot of dark scenes in this film, so they've done a great job of taking the shadow detail again, and then you have a lot of brightness and contrast to it, and it looks spectacular. Whatever type of television you're watching this on, this will be something that you want to show off as well. And it's just a lot of fun as a movie. Goodfellas, watch this briefly. I'm a big fan of the film, but I think the Blu-ray of this looks better than the 4K version. I found it very grainy. Only got about an hour into the film, so I don't know if anything else changes. But I was kind of disappointed by this because I really love this movie. Audio was good, but you know the audio on the Blu-ray is good as well. But I thought the Blu-ray version was a little bit stronger than this. But again, I got this on discount on Boxing Day week, so I just grabbed it. Angels and Demons. This movie is finished at just over 2K, but an upscaled. But again, it's one of those movies that looks referenced because they did such a good job at it. Beautiful movie to look at, just based on the scenery, the places they go. Its audio is amazing. The movie itself is so-so. I think it's better than the Da Vinci Code was. If I gave Da Vinci Code out of 5, I think I'd say Da Vinci Code was 2.5. 3, this is then a 3.5. But it does look pretty spectacular. So if you can get this, again, if you're looking for eye candy and you can pick this up on sale, I would say grab it. If you're looking for great movies for your collection, don't bother. Sicario. As I said back in my review, just breathtaking. Blu-ray's amazing. 4K just takes it to the next level with the HDR. The detail and the shadows, you just see more of what's going on. It brings the movie more to life. It has more realism to it. And it's just, audio-wise, it's spectacular. But movie-wise, this is a 5. This is one of my favorite films on any format. But on 4K, this is definitely something I would pick up. I mean, I own this on Blu-ray. I own the Steelbook, and I bought this again, so I can tell you how much I like this movie. X-Men Apocalypse. Audio, amazing. Video, amazing. Movie, didn't think it was very good. I would give it out of 5. The movie, I would give it a 2.5. I really didn't like it. And I watched it twice, trying to. Good cast, but it seemed like more of a money grab movie to me. I didn't think the story was compelling. I thought it was very predictable. This Quicksilver scene was cool, definitely. But a lot of the rest of the film, I think I don't know why they made this. But so again, if you're a big X-Men fan or you like this film, yeah, it's worth picking up. If you aren't, no. Maze Runner, Scorch Trials. I really like this film. And I think it was a very good-looking film in its 4K. I did compare it to its Blu-ray version because it came with this. I didn't own it on Blu-ray before it. And it is a better copy. It is better than the Blu-ray version. But you know, if you're a fan of like the Hunger Games and that kind of thing, you'll probably enjoy this movie. If you're not, it's not worth the extra money to pick this up. Oh wait, that was a Scorch Trial. So I did the Scorch Trials first. This is the Maze Runner. The Maze Runner was the movie I actually enjoyed. And a good transfer. Again, comparing it to the Blu-ray. They're pretty much the same when you think about both of these as far as the transfer is concerned. The Scorch Trials is a little bit better of a transfer, I think, than the Maze Runner, but they're both good. Both have great audio, but I felt this film was a little bit more enjoyable than this one. This was good as well. It had its moments, and there were moments, too, where I rolled my eyes a lot, but I don't know how much further I'd want to go with this series. If there's one more movie, I may purchase it just to finish things. But if I didn't own this, would I purchase it on 4K if I had other choices and was standing in the store having to buy this or something else? Either of these movies? No. Angry Birds. I really enjoyed this film. Has more of an adult tone to it, but it's very colorful. It looks great on the Blu-ray. The 4K version, though, is just, again, cut with a razor. Brings anything digital. Imagine getting it, you know, with a 4K upscale or you know, an HDR added to it. It looks great. It looks great. The first, I think, 3/4 of the film are really good, and then the last section was kind of okay. Yeah, let's just end this. And now they're playing into the Angry Birds thing. But I had a lot of good laughs with this movie, and I did think it was a. It's very much eye candy, and if you have kids and you want to have something you can throw into your 4K player so you can enjoy it by just watching your content and then having your kids like the film, this is worth a pickup, definitely. X-Men First Class, or sorry, this is X-Men Days of Future Past. Really good movie. Took me two or three viewings to believe that, but very good movie, very clean transfer. Doesn't really take some advantage of the HDR so much. It's more like The Kingsman, where you benefit more so from the detail and the uptick in audio than you do from the high dynamic range. But it's a very good looking movie. It looks good on Blu-ray too. So if I owned a Blu-ray of this, which I do, would I buy this again if I had to make the choice now? No, probably not. But if I didn't own this, or if I was a real stickler for picture quality as I am, I would pick this up. Last Witch Hunter. Movie looks incredible. There's certain scenes, just simple things. There's a scene where this girl is sitting against like this brick wall, and just the detail on the brick behind her and the color handling and everything. This movie is gorgeous. Sound quality wise, it's also spectacular. Movie wise, I thought it was pretty terrible. You know, not like I'm going to vomit on my shoes terrible, but it's more like I'm going to dry heave and hope I don't. You know, so this is kind of up to you. This is one of those movies I find people love it or hate it. And if you love it, yeah, it's worth it in 4K. If you hate it, don't bother. Lego Movie. So, Lego Movie, great film. Looks amazing in 4K, of course, digital. Sound quality is amazing. I don't have much else to say about this film, except if you have a 4K setup and you like this movie, then this is definitely worth getting. Peanuts Movie, again, looks spectacular, good audio, good story, especially if you have children to sort of teach them the value of some of the things you don't find in movies today. And if you were a Charlie Brown fan growing up, you'll really like this movie. Yeah, it's underrated, I think, almost. And people never seem to talk about it when the 4K in their 4K reviews, but this is a very good film. Independence Day. Saw this film as back in the day in the theater. Transfer is good. It's better than the Blu-ray, but it's not as good as some of the reference 4K films. The movie, I think, hasn't aged as well as I thought it would. I still enjoy it, but it's not in the same manner I did back then, where I used to watch it over and over when I first got it on Blu-ray. It's decent, but again, I think this is one of those films you wait for a Black Friday, you know, a couple of years from now, you walk into the store and it's on sale for like $12.99 in 4K, that I'd pick it up then. Ghostbusters, the first one, the only one, much better version than the Blu-ray version. Sound quality is great. Picture quality is really good for a movie this age. There are moments when you can see the grain and you kind of think, yeah, okay, I could see the age in the film. But for the most part, for what they did to upgrade the film, it looks really good. It's you know, especially if you have new equipment and you want to get the most out of it. This is definitely, I think, film I would say to pick up if you're a Ghostbusters fan. Deadpool. Not much to say about Deadpool. Movie's incredible. The transfer is incredible. The audio is incredible. It's Deadpool. I'm sure every one of you watching this now probably already owns this. And if you don't, I don't know what you're thinking. But this should be in your 4K collection. Man of Steel. Good film. Great transfer. HDR adds a lot to it. Out of 5, the movie to me is a 3.5. Some great action sequences, moments where you really get the benefit of the HDR, especially in the early scenes where Jor-El is trying to get the codex from Krypton. And it really takes advantage of the HDR in those scenes. And again, audio-wise, spectacular. This is more of a I'm a Man of Steel Superman movie fan person. If you own a lot of other content, you're just trying to pick something else up, okay. If not, you know, this is really about whether or not you're a Superman fan or not. If you're not a Superman fan, then you probably won't want to repurchase this if you own it on Blu-ray. Batman vs. Superman. Now, they should have taken the Frank Miller comic books and just followed those, but I hated this movie the first time I saw it, and I've seen it twice since, and now I'm more of a fan, especially with this version where they added scenes back to it. The Ultimate Edition puts things more in context for me, so I'm like, okay, I can sort of see how some of that would have happened. It looks beautiful in its 4K transfer. Audio, of course, is great in this kind of movie. Really good scenes in this film. Some areas where I roll my eyes or it's just too slow, but it is a good film. And I would say something that's worth picking up if you want a good 4K image and you want to give your surround sound speakers a real workout. Well, let's start, actually. They're in a reverse order. So, Star Trek. Great film. Very good transfer. Very good audio. If you're a Star Trek fan, it's a no-brainer. It's highly recommended by me. Star Trek Into Darkness. Again, I think an even better picture quality than the first one. They're both very, very good. Audio is spectacular, just like the first one. Movie itself, I don't think, is as strong as the first film. They should have done more with the Klingons, in my opinion, or at least done that with the third film. But it's good. It's a good time waster. And in 4K, it's even better than it was on Blu-ray. Especially the early scenes when they're on that, if you looked at my review, the early scenes when they're on that primitive planet look spectacular. Star Trek Beyond. I don't think this is the same quality of transfer as the first two. I think it's decent. It has moments where it's breathtaking. But a lot of moments, too, I find in some of the space scenes where you get a lot of, there is light bleed. And I can imagine even on the OLED, it may appear sometimes to be like light bleed, because I don't think it's actually the TV bleeding light. It seems to be just the way it's filmed that there are moments where it looks like you're getting a lot of light bleed on the screen. The audio's amazing. Of course it would be. But I found the story itself was kind of mediocre. Again, I think they should have done a Klingon story here. I thought the whole, I'm a big Idris Elba fan, but I didn't really enjoy the storyline that much. It's not like the other films where immediately I want to watch them again. This one, when it was over, I've kind of watched it and I've gone back and tried to watch it again, but haven't really been able to get into it. The Hunger Games: Catching Fire, my favorite of the Hunger Games films, so the only one I've repurchased in 4K because I own the others in Blu-ray. Looks spectacular. This is more of the Hunger Games to me on steroids. Better environments for the battles, especially that sort of that area they put them with the water and all the trees, and it just looks, it pops in 4K. And I think the movie, again, in my opinion, is the best of the movies. So I did repurchase this. Audio quality is amazing. If you own the Hunger Games films already, this may be, I'd say this is the only one to repurchase on 4K. Or if you're happy with the Blu-rays, then no, I wouldn't go back and repurchase all of these. Deepwater Horizon, Peter Berg, great film. Transfer is good. It has a little bit of a grainy look to it at times, but I think that's kind of what they were going for. They didn't want it to look too much like digital or really sharp video. But the HD version, the 4K version is, or the UHD version is a big, is a good jump over the Blu-ray version. But the Blu-ray version also looks really good and sounds great. I didn't own this on Blu-ray. Now that I have 4K and all the setup for it, there was no reason for me to buy this on Blu-ray when it was released at the same time as the 4K. So recommend it if you like great cinema and Peter Berg films. I Am Legend, really good film. It looks a lot like the Blu-ray to me, just added some HDR, some more bright areas. It doesn't seem that much more detailed. You do get more detail in the shadow areas, like when he goes into that building and first finds that nest, you know, of those creatures. But I noticed the sharpness in certain other things is not any different than the Blu-ray. So it's up to you whether you repurchase this on in 4K. But also, it's also one of the budget titles. But I wouldn't, if I had the Blu-ray and had to do it over again, I don't know necessarily that I'd buy this a second time. Sully. Tried to put up this video, was taken down immediately, so I just said whatever. But 4K digital intermediate, 4K CGI, it's breathtaking, and it's a very good movie. It's something that I would say anybody should own in their collection if they like good 4K and want to show off their system. This would, I can imagine, will look amazing on a bigger screen or on a projector, especially like the Sony projector, and that's 4K HDR. I know it's like, I think, what, $10,000 for the thing, but you know, this is the kind of technology that's made for those who, like, that kind of advancement. Or if you have 4K HDR in your home, this is one of those films that will show you why. And Tom Hanks is great in this, so. San Andreas looks great, sounds great, movie's okay, but one of my first pickups, movie's not, the movie's, it's turn your brain off. It's like Independence Day or anything else like that. You know, a big apocalyptic film, hero running around doing things that are really impossible. But the movie itself, it's decent. I, though, don't know how much I'd recommend this unless you found it in the bargain bin. Spider-Man. This movie looks spectacular. It sounds spectacular, but the movie itself is terrible. I had to watch this through in like 4 days. I hated this movie. Like, it was like Spider-Man 3. Terrible. And I liked the first version of these movies with Andrew Garfield, but this was too hard to take. Too much going on, too many different characters, bad casting. But as eye candy and ear candy, worth a pickup. Sausage Party. This movie is for acquired taste. Do not let your children watch this digitally, because it is a digital film. It looks spectacular. You really have to like let go and take the stick out of your butt and watch this. And if you do, you'll have a good laugh. Ending scene to me was a little bit much, but audio wise, it's very good. Video wise, of course, being digital, it looks great. But I can't even rate this, because it's really a personal taste kind of thing. If you offend easily, don't even bother. If you see this on the shelf, run. If you don't, you may actually enjoy this. Creed. I have the Blu-ray. Did not expect to repurchase this, but a YouTuber I respect gave it a really good review, so I decided to pick it up. And it is, the Blu-ray looks amazing, and this is even better. And the audio is great. The HDR that it adds to it is great. Great film. This is another, if you like great cinema, and you're not just about buying action or eye candy, but want great-looking films with great audio and also want really good content, this is one to pick up. Okay, we're getting down to the end. Magnificent Seven. I did a review on this. Yeah, it's up, but you actually can see sort of the images I took a look at. My review was really based on this versus the Magnificent Seven remake, the first one with Yul Brynner. I've also owned the Seven Samurai, which is great. But in my opinion, this is the best version of all three. Great cast in Denzel Washington, Chris Pratt. The Blu-ray looks really good. The 4K with the HDR is spectacular. Audio is spectacular. The story is spectacular. I love Westerns. But if you're a Western fan, you definitely have to own this. If you aren't, but you like great films, you definitely have to own this. So I would say definitely a thumbs up for me. Crouching Tiger, Hidden Dragon. Great looking film, 4K digital intermediate. Great movie. Audio is really good. It's just hard to watch through because it's such a long film. There can be really, really slow sections in this movie. So unless you're somebody who doesn't mind the slow burn, you may not want to pick this up. It is hard to find now, I've noticed. I'm assuming they didn't expect there to be, a ton of people rushing to the stores to pick this up, so released it in limited numbers. But it is a very, very good-looking film if you like eye candy, but as far as something you're going to sit through often and watch over again, this isn't that film. This is more of a, I like this film, I want it in my collection, and if that's the case, then you should own this. Oh, whole pile just fell on the ground, but that's what happens when you own a lot of stuff. So, Bourne Identity. Really good-looking transfer. Takes advantage of the HDR. Again, any film where you have people going to, like, Europe and all these other different places, if it's filmed well, it looks great. And this movie has a lot of really good cinematography, so it was worth the upgrade to me, especially with the HDR. Really enjoy this film as a film. Picture quality wise, I would definitely give it a 4.5 out of 5. 4.5. There are certain moments where it gets a little bit weaker, but for the most part, it looks good. Audio is really good, and this is a 5 for me as a movie. Bourne Ultimatum. I haven't watched this one yet, and these are the only two I bought because I own the whole Bourne series on Blu-ray, and they look really good, and these to me were by far the two strongest of the films, so I wasn't going to repurchase all of them. Supremacy was tempting, but I just didn't bother. And Bourne Legacy, no. So I haven't watched this yet, but I'm assuming if Identity looks as good, and this is a little bit of a film that came out after Identity, it'll look pretty spectacular as well. Jason Bourne, was not going to buy this. I saw this movie in the theaters, and I thought it was terrible. Not terrible, I just didn't think it was great. But one of the first sort of 4K steelbooks out there, and I figured whatever, you know, I got it again on, I got this on sale. So I ended up just grabbing it, and the transfer looks spectacular, and the sound is great, but the film to me is still pretty mediocre. Suicide Squad. The reason Angry Joe should not be doing movie reviews. This movie is not good. I'm sorry, but Steelbook's cool. Movie looks really good. Good idea. Will Smith was good. Margot Robbie was good. You know, yeah, the Joker was good in the small parts they gave him, but it reminded me of The Last of Us and The Walking Dead, like they were trying to fuse all of that together in a movie, and I just didn't care about the characters or anything that was going on. I'm not a big fan, but if you are, no offense to you. I mean, hey, cool. We all like different things, but I just did not think this was great. Okay, X-Men First Class. Great transfer, great audio, very good film, definitely worth picking up. It seems like it's harder to get as well lately, but if you're an X-Men fan and you're a 4K fan, this movie took me a little while to really start to appreciate, but yeah, I give it a 4.5 movie-wise, video-wise, it's a 4.5, audio-wise, it's a 5. And last but not least, Underworld. I love this movie. I've owned a number of different versions on Blu-ray. I own all of the Underworld films to date. Was hoping this would be worth it as a 4K transfer, and I've got to say, I'm not impressed. Unless I put this in movie mode to really darken it down and hide the imperfections, this movie does not look good. It's not a great transfer. It's decent, but you really have to play with your image. And I don't want to have to be playing with my TV settings constantly to try to dial in a picture for a movie like this. I just want to be able to throw it in, and as with most of my other films, just go wow. So as a movie, to me, Underworld for my taste is a 4.5 for my taste, and not, and based on this specific type of movie, video wise it's I think it's a 3, and audio wise it's pretty good, but it's still not some of the better audio tracks I've heard in the past couple of years. Audio-wise, I'd say it's also a 4.5. So, anyway, that's it. I don't know how long this video is going to be. I'm assuming it's going to be like 8 hours based on how long I feel like I've been talking. But if you have any questions about any of this stuff or want me to try to get a review up, I can't promise anything because it all takes time. But I will at least try to answer your questions. So anyway, yeah. I hope you guys have an amazing day, and we'll be talking soon.